And now we will finally make our first transaction. Video 8, depositing income. It is so simple to record the event when you deposit income. First, you can use the register of the account that the money came into. In that register, just record all relevant information, like when the transaction was, whom it was with, why and how you got the money, what number it was, and how much money it is. That's the relevant information, and you can put it in very easily. Then you can check your results in the trial balance. For example, let's imagine on June 1, you received $1,000, or Joe received $1,000 pay from Molly's saloon for bartending. Then he deposited check number 8472 into the M&T bank account. Let's take a look at how we would record this. We can check our trial balance before we start and see that all the numbers are starting at zero. Now, let's open up the M&T register and simply record the relevant information. To put in a date, click the calendar box, and it just so happens we're in the correct month. If we were not in the correct month, you would click back or forward to get the correct month, then simply click on the day that the job was, or the day that the deposit was. Then click in the number field and put the number of the check that you deposited. In this case, it's check number 8472. So let's put 8472, and that will help us reference it. Now, the payee is really the person involved. We know that Joe got paid. However, he got paid from Molly's saloon, and this will help you keep track of how much money came in from one particular person or company. Now, what did he earn from Molly's saloon? What type of income? In this case, he earned bartending income. So we have the when, the what number, the who, and the why. Now we need to know how much. Now, he was actually depositing this money into M&T Bank, so you have to be very careful to choose the deposit column, not the payment column. Type in 1,000, and then to save a number or information in a field, push the tab key on the left of your keyboard. That actually records the transaction. You could have also clicked the record button, and then of course the cursor moves down one row. When we check the results in the trial balance, you can see that we now have $1,000 of bartending income, and the balance of the M&T bank is $1,000. Let's take a look at the next one together. June 2. Deposited $500 pay from the Beer and Go, also for bartending, but in this case it wasn't a check. It was direct deposit into the Chase bank account, and the confirmation is number 12345. So how would we record this? Well, it did go into the Chase bank account. So let's close the M&T register and open the Chase register. The date was June 2nd. What was that long number again? That number was 12345. So the confirmation number for the transaction was 12345. And even though Joe got paid, the money came from the Beer and Go. So you can track how much money came in from whom. The account in this case, or the reason why you got paid, is again bartending income. You must be very careful to put the money in the deposit column, not the payment column. Push tab, and now you've recorded that transaction. You could have also clicked record to record that transaction. Now when we look at our trial balance, you can see that M&T Bank has a balance of $1,000, Chase Bank has a balance of $500, but the total bartending income, the total money that came in for this particular reason, is $1,500. Now, this last one is very interesting. June 3rd, Joe withdrew $200 from M&T Bank for cash on hand, just to have cash to keep in his wallet. And of course, the ATM slip is the document that's proof, and here's the number. How would you record it? Well, in this case, you have two options. You could record it as a decrease in the M&T bank account register, or you could record it as an increase in the cash on hand register. The result will be the same no matter which register you record it in. Let's take a look. Okay, let's close out whatever other windows you had open and click cash on hand and open the register for your cash on hand. The date was June 3rd. The number on the ATM slip was 98765. Now, even though Joe was the payee, actually Joe is the payee and he's not on the list. No problem. We can click add new. And we can add Joe as a vendor, leave the vendor choice, and this is how we would add a payee on the fly. Click OK and just type in Joe. And Joe will be added to your vendor list so you can have him there as a payee. Click OK. Now here's the interesting part. The money came to cash on hand, but the money came from M&T Bank. If you put M&T Bank in the account, QuickBooks will record this both in the cash on hand register and copy it over to the M&T Bank register when you're done. Now, because you're in the cash on hand register, it's a deposit to your wallet. So put 200 and click record. When we look at the trial balance, we can see that M&T Bank has decreased down from 1,000 to 800, and we can see cash on hand, which is cash in your wallet, has gone up to 200. Now let's think about this trial balance for a minute. Okay, the M&T Bank account has two transactions that add up to 800, a deposit of 1,000 and a withdrawal of 200. When you double click the total balance of any number in the trial balance, you get a list of every transaction that adds up to that balance. So on June 1, you had an increase from 0 to 1,000 from Molly's Saloon. Then on June 3rd, you had a decrease because Joe took out money from the ATM and it brought it down to 800. Let's close it out. By the way, you should also look at your bartending income. You can double click and find out why is my bartending income $1,500. Well, that's because on June 1, you deposited a check from Molly's Saloon for bartending income. And June 2, you deposited a different check from the Beer and Go into Chase Bank. That's why the total that you earned for bartending income is $1,500. I'd like to mention one last thing about that last transaction. Even though the last transaction was recorded in this register, cash on hand, because we chose the M&T bank account as the account, QuickBooks automatically copied it to this register. When we click here, you can see that the June 3rd transaction with the same ATM slip number and the same payee has been copied into the M&T register. But this very same transaction in the M&T register is in the payment column because it decreases this account. And notice in this account, for the very same transaction, the account is cash on hand. So whenever you record a transaction in one register and choose another register as the account, QuickBooks will automatically copy that same transaction into the other register. So it doesn't matter which one you record it in if money goes from one account to another.